Hello students, in the last class we studied about the electrode potential concept, the standard electrode potential concept. Electrode potential is what? It is the electron lost or gained by the electrode. And standard electrode potential means the conditions are standard when the electrode potential is calculated. Standard conditions are basically the concentration of the salt solution should be 1 molar, the temperature should be 25 degrees Celsius or 298 Kelvin. And if gas is involved, then the pressure of the gas should be 1 bar. Apart from this, we studied about the standard electrode, standard hydrogen electrode, that is SHE. Basically, the importance of the significance of standard hydrogen electrode is important here. So, what is the significance? It is used to calculate the standard electrode potential of any unknown electrode by connecting that unknown electrode with this SHE. So how this works and everything I explained you in my last lecture. This was just a recap of the last lecture. Then we today's class we'll study about the electrochemical series. The electrochemical series and the Nernst equation, both the topics are extremely important for this in this chapter, because most of the questions in your boards are asked from Nernst equation only, and Nernst equation is based on this electrochemical series. So children, what is electrochemical series? It is a series in which the metals are arranged in increasing order of their reduction potential. I repeat again, it is a series of metals in which the metals are arranged in increasing order of their reduction potential or decreasing order of their oxidation potential. So basically you can relate it with the reactivity series. If you remember, you have learnt a reactivity series where the most electropositive metals or the most reactive metals are placed at the top and the least electropositive metals like gold, silver, platinum are placed at the bottom, and the elements placed at the top of the series are capable of displacing the elements which are placed at the bottom of the series from the salt. So this series can be related to that activity series only. Here also you can see that lithium, it is one of the most reactive metal, is placed at the top of the series, and silver, which is one of the least reactive metal, is placed at the bottom of the series. Now why I am calling it increasing reduction potential? Increasing reduction potential means the metal at the top, has the lowest reduction potential. That is, it has a tendency to get oxidized easily. Why? Because it is the most electropositive element. Electropositivity means tendency to lose electron, and again tendency to lose electron means getting oxidized. Is it clear? So lithium, being the most reactive element, being the most electropositive element, will have a tendency to lose electron, therefore it will get oxidized, therefore it will have the lowest reduction potential. As you move down the series, what happens? The tendency to get oxidized will go on decreasing. Therefore, the reduction potential will go on increasing. It will be better reducing agent and, in comparison to this silver. I hope the series is clear. In short, you can say that this series helps us in identifying that if two metals are given to you to construct a cell, then which metal will behave as anode and which metal will behave as cathode. So the metal which is present at the top of the series are going to behave as anode, and the metal which is present at the bottom of the series will behave as cathode. Suppose I take an example of lithium aluminium cell. If I compare lithium and aluminium and I construct a cell using these two metals, then obviously lithium will behave, being more electropositive, being more reactive, will behave as anode, and aluminium present below lithium will behave as cathode. So this helps in identifying the nature of the metal when they are connected to form a electrochemical cell. So you don't have to remember the values of reduction potential. You simply need to remember the position of these metals. This you can easily remember by correlating it with the metal reactivity series. I hope it is clear to you. If it is not clear to you, children, you can pause the video, you can try to understand it, and then you can ask your doubt, and because you need to apply it in the Nernst equation. Okay, so now I'm coming to some more applications of electrochemical series. Most of the applications I've already discussed while explaining the series. Now let us see some more. Okay, the first point is metals with low standard reduction potential. Metals with low standard reduction potential get oxidized. Okay, now let's find out from the series. You can see here the lowest reduction potential here is of lithium with the value -3.05 volt. So this has the lowest reduction potential, so it will get oxidized, and if it is getting oxidized, obviously it will form anode. Now contrary to this, metals with high SRP, that is standard reduction potential, get reduced. So having high SRP will get reduced, so obviously it is going to form cathode. This application I've already discussed. Now next point, if standard reduction potential of a metal is less than equal to -2 volt, then it is the most electropositive element. As you can see in the series, lithium has a value of -3.05 volt, which is less than -2 volts, so obviously it will be most electropositive element. That is, it is more readily going to lose electron in comparison to others. Now if the SRP ranges between 0 to 2 volt, it will be moderately electropositive, and if the SRP is more than 0, then it will be weakly electropositive in nature. And again, electropositive is not a new term, children. Electropositivity means tendency to lose electron, tendency to get oxidized easily. Okay, now third point is metals with least SRP. Again, from the series, the least SRP is of lithium. If you compare it with other metals, you can see that with the negative sign, the highest value is of lithium. So it has the least SRP, so obviously it will be having highest reactivity in comparison to other elements in the electrochemical series. So these were the important applications of the electrochemical series that you must know. So I hope the electrochemical series topic is clear to you. I repeat, electrochemical series is a series where the metals are arranged in increasing order of their reduction potential. I'm taking reduction potential because the values here are given for reduction potential only. You can see Li plus is getting converted into Li. That is, reduction in the positive charge means it is getting reduced. And since I have calculated the reduction potential only, I have taken the values of reduction potential only. Therefore, this series is according to the increasing order of reduction potential only. And electrode potential is usually calculated in terms of standard reduction potential only, not oxidation potential. Please remember this, children. And for oxidation potential, what happens? Only the sign get reversed. If